Hey guys, welcome to the Mosconi Lab to part 3 of our DSP tutorial. Today we want to measure the frequency response of an OIM head unit and adjust it with the input equalizer. And then we want to have a look on a static input equalizer and our dynamic input equalizer. Okay, let's go on. As usual, I'm already connected with the GUI. In the background, I have a measuring tool. Okay, back to GUI. What have I done? I have my Pico A12 DSP. I have connected an Volkswagen OEM car stereo on the analog input 1 and 2. For this, I show you a little trick in the block view. Here, the input analog 1 and 2. You can change the name. I can change it to head unit Volkswagen OEM and stored. And now, if you the name is stored in the DSP. And if you call back the data in another year back to the GUI, on this place will show head unit VW OEM. That's by the way. Okay, back to home. As I said, connected to analog input 1 and 2. How can I measure the frequency response of my OEM car stereo? It's quite easy. I have an CD in the car stereo with a white noise. White noise have the same level from bass to the mid-range to the high frequencies, all the same level. It's connected to the DSP, and the output from DSP is connected to an USB sound card with a normal IRTA measuring program. I use for this ARTA. It's my program. I can use it. Okay. So let's go on. I switch on the radio. You hear the white noise. The white noise is also on the output, so I can start the measuring of ARTA. I reset the measure. Wait. Yes. Okay, I see the frequency response of the radio. I see a big peak, more or less 12-13 dB by 75-80 Hertz, and I see a dip frequency response from 8 kHz up to 20 kHz. So I have too much bass, too much over bass. The real bass, the deep bass is normal. And I have two less high frequencies. To adjust this, it's not a big problem for an input equalizer. For this, I need one or two bands. As I told, around about 75-80 Hertz with a low Q. In high bandwidth, it's a very wide peak. Okay, reset, measure again. Wait. I have to decrease this frequency. Okay, with this one equalizer band, my frequency response in the base is more or less equal. I have a light peak by 150 Hz. I can correct it, no problem. Another band in low Q, 150 Hz. Okay, pull down 2 or 2.5 dB, measure again, and the frequency response in the bass is flat. Now I push the high frequencies, I choose a frequency of 20 kHz, it's a very low Q, push it 5 or 5.5 dB, do the measuring, and I see my frequency response is more or less totally flat. I can work with it. As I told, this is not a big problem for each input equalizer in a DSP. The problem is the OEM car stereos works dynamic. It means the equalizing the equalizing in the radio is changed by the volume. If I push up the volume, wait. So there's my white noise back again. I push up the volume and you see the frequency response . Mute the speakers so you can hear me. This is a high volume, the frequency response of the high volume, and I see the dynamic equalizing of the stereo, of the radio. The bass that was too high by low volumes, now I miss by high volumes. So I miss in the bass from 60 to 100 Hz, I have a gap around about 8 dB. And at this point, every normal input equalizer can't do more, because you can set up it only for one volume. If you change the volume, the equalizer setting goes more and more wrong. What can we do with the Mosconi DSP? We can make it dynamic. For this, we have to know the volume in the car. And this volume in the car we can get on two different ways. We can read it from the CAN bus with the RC CAN remote interface. The RC CAN remote interface read the set volume in the car digital from the CAN bus and give it to the DSP, and the DSP can work with it. Can, for example, choose the right equalizer setting. If you don't have a CAN bus connection, you can say my Mosconi DSP should measure the volume. I choose this option. Now the DSP measure the volume, and this show in EQ button high is gone active. What it means, we have set it the input equalizer for low volumes with a low white noise. Now we do the same for high volumes by the measuring, and by low we have the 75 Hz with a minus of 12 dB. Now by the high volume, we choose the same frequency, 775, and put it down 1 or 1.5 dB. And we see by high volumes, the high frequency also become a gap. So we do the same by the equalizer for high volumes, push the high frequencies, 5 dB, start the measuring again. So start again. Now we have a more or less flat frequency response. We have a little bit too much high frequency. We have a little bit too much low frequency. We can adjust it in this way. Measure again. Perfect. Flat frequency response by high volumes from low frequency to high frequencies, more or less. There's a little bit too less by the high frequencies. So now that's it. And what the DSP now done is for all volumes between the low setting and the high setting, the DSP interpolate the right DSP setting. I show you, this is the measured curve for very high volume. Now I set the volume between low and high. Start the measuring again. And I get a flat frequency response. I put it back to low, measure again, and have a flat frequency response. I do it high, but not totally high. Reset the measuring, and I have a flat frequency response. Okay, we have it. This dynamic input equalizer, depend by the volume, is only possible at the moment with the Mosconi DSP. It's a very powerful tool to manage OEM car stereos. Sorry, I'm a little bit ill. And you can use it to equalize a dynamic OEM equalizer or a dynamic OEM frequency response. You also can use it to build your own loudness curve. For example, I do for low frequencies a little more bass. And a little more high frequencies. Okay. Now I pull down the volume. And measure. And I have a loudness curve. I have a little bit more bass and I have a little bit more high frequencies. And when I do louder and louder, the response goes more and more flat. Do it louder. And I have a flat frequency response. You also see the OEM car stereo cut the bass below 50 Hz. with a filter. How we correct this filter to get the right bass from 20 Hertz, I show you tomorrow. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Have a nice evening. See you tomorrow.